In this video, I will give you every player that you need to succeed for DraftKings Showdown Captain Mode on Sunday Night Football as the Seattle Seahawks fly out to the Northeast to take on the second coming of the New England Patriots' dominance with a younger, more athletic QB under center. My name's Quick Pick Nick, and having simulated hundreds of thousands of different lineup formats, here are your locks and lotteries for Sunday Night Football on September 20th. If you like fast-paced, calculated content like this, be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for more lineups, including a FanDuel lineup for Monday Night Football going live tomorrow morning. For the first lock of this lineup and the MVP player for this slate, my model recommends selecting Chris Carson. Out of the top 10 lineups simulated, ranked by projected fantasy points, Carson was present the most often, appearing 9 out of 10 times. Carson proved in week 1 that he is able to put up numbers as big as any quarterback, scoring nearly 25 fantasy points with 2 receiving touchdowns and 6 receptions. In addition, Carson's workload is expected to even increase from here, which is insane considering his already massive upside, as he was likely eased into the first week having recovered from a hip injury. To top all that off, Carson is significantly cheaper than the quarterbacks, pricing almost $5,000 cheaper than Wilson as MVP. Carson will be the most influential player in your lineup given his relatively low cost, and should be in your lineup for tonight's game. Following our MVP with another lock, my model recommends taking N'Keal Harry. If Harry is active for the game, which is likely considering Bill Belichick's reputation of loading up the injury report early in the week, Harry should be considered the most valuable wide receiver in this slate. Harry was as popular of a target as Julian Edelman for Cam Newton in week 1, as they both managed 5 receptions against the Dolphins. The expectation is for Newton to throw more often than he did last Sunday, as he rushed just as many times as he passed, so look for Harry's numbers to go up even further tonight. His cheap cost locks him in here, given the fact that he only cost $5,200, which places him just above defenses, a price that is quite the steal considering Harry's high ceiling. The third and final lock for this slate is going to be the quarterback throwing to Harry, that being the new face of the New England Patriots, Cam Newton. The Newton we saw last Sunday looked just like the Newton we saw back in 2015, rushing 15 times himself for 75 yards and 2 touchdowns. It would appear as if Cam Newton is as good as he's ever been, coming back fully healed from a foot injury that held him back since 2016. With no holds barred and the biggest chip on his shoulder in the league, Newton has everything to prove and will continue to do so against the Seahawks, who allowed Matt Ryan 25 fantasy points last week. Before getting into the lotteries, one player, or rather position, that I would consider a limbo pick is the kicker. In all 10 of the top 10 projected lineups, there was at least one kicker present, with some even including two. This top lineup that I'm currently presenting only includes one, that being Jason Myers, Seattle's kicker, but some of the other include Nick Folk instead, or even Myers and Folk. It seems that my model is suggesting that taking at least one kicker is probably a good idea for the slate, as they are relatively cheaper for a player who can reasonably be expected to score 7 or more points per game. With the kicker, or kickers, out of the way, for the two lottery picks of this lineup, my model chose Tyler Lockett and the Seattle Seahawks defense. Lockett was selected because he is Russell Wilson's primary target, and a reliable target at that. Wilson threw the ball Lockett's way 8 times in week 1, and Lockett was able to bring in every single one, netting 92 receiving yards on 8 catches. The reason for Lockett's placement at the lottery is because DK Metcalf may steal the spotlight, which did happen against the Falcons, with Metcalf taking a touchdown for himself, leaving Lockett with none. However, Lockett is still the more consistent and reliable choice overall, which justifies his placement in this lineup. As for the Seahawks, they are in this lineup simply because it fits really nicely with the rest of the cast. They were able to sustain fantasy value even with a high-scoring game against the Falcons, ending with 6 fantasy points while Atlanta still scored 25 points. I wouldn't be too concerned about either the Seahawks defense or the Patriots players kneecapping each other, as we saw last week that both can coexist successfully. And that's what my model was able to come up with for DraftKings Showdown Captain Mode on Sunday Night Football. If you enjoy these lineup builders, be a friend, tell a friend. Let's grow the Quick Pick Network together. This has been Quick Pick Nick, the intersection for sports, data analysis, and speed. Thanks for watching.